Switzerland is known as one of the most beautiful countries in the world, but that view comes at a price. It is one of the most gorgeous destinations that we've ever been to, but it's also one of the most expensive. We've traveled across Switzerland for 10 days, hitting 6 different cities for a total of about 2.3 thousand Singapore dollars. And in this video, we want to show you how to do the same. So, here is our Switzerland budget travel guide. Hello, my name is Clarence, and in this video, I want to show you how you can make the most out of your trip to Switzerland. And we visited Lucerne, Interlaken, Montreux, Zermatt, St. Moritz, and Zurich, all for $2,300. And the timestamps for each of these cities will be in the description below, so check it out. Also, do remember to check out our Switzerland itineraries in the description below. They are great if you want proper budget breakdowns or if you want to do a little bit more research. And before we get started, do remember to hit that subscribe button if you're already subscribed. I'm proud of you, man. All right, let's get started. So let's start off with getting to Switzerland. Our itinerary starts in Zurich, so you want to book a flight there. Prices fluctuate all throughout the year, but what we found is that flights are significantly cheaper if you fly from within Europe. So if your direct flight is a little bit too pricey, do consider choosing a connecting flight from Europe instead, preferably major cities like London or Paris. And once you're there, you're gonna need lodging. Hotels in Switzerland are notoriously expensive, but you can find Airbnbs and hostels for pretty cheap if you plan it right. So the hostels and Airbnbs we were at cost about $30 to $100 per person, but in the peak periods, it might be a little bit more expensive than that. But overall, I think accommodations under $100 is quite affordable. After settling your flights, after settling your accommodations, we're gonna be talking about food. I don't think people go to Switzerland for the food. People go there for the views because the food is expensive, right? We all know that. A dinner out will run you about $100. So instead, what you can do is go find some good deals at any supermarket or grocery store. So we save money by buying ingredients in the discount section and either cooking them or bringing them out for a picnic. And lastly, you're gonna want transportation. You can rent a car, but the petrol in Switzerland is very, very expensive. So we highly, highly recommend that you get a Swiss travel pass. It allows you to use the trains, it allows you to use the buses, the boats, all over the country. You even get access to cargo cableways and gondolas. And much of our itinerary relies on this Swiss travel pass. So it is absolutely essential if you want to hit multiple cities during your trip. And do check out our guide in the description if you want to find out how to maximize your Swiss travel pass. Okay, and on to the actual guide now. So after landing in Zurich International Airport, you want to head over to the historic city of Lucerne. It just takes you about an hour's drive to reach Lucerne from Zurich Airport. So Lucerne has a very nice laid-back vibe. You can explore its charismatic old town, and then you can take a nice relaxing boat ride on Lake Lucerne. You can also opt to take the famous Golden Round trip and get to the top of Mount Pilatus. And if you have that Swiss travel pass, then all the transport for this trip is included 100%. So, starting at the base, you get to take the world's steepest cogwheel railway. And for the best views, you'd want to sit on the sides of the cabin. After about 30 minutes, you'll reach the top of Mount Pilatus, and it's here you get to enjoy a panoramic view of the Swiss Alps. And for a quick way down the mountain, you can even jump on a toboggan and slide your way down, and it sure as hell beats walking down the side of the mountain. You can also choose to take a quick drive out to Bergenstock. It's a very nice little hike, and at the end, you'll reach the highest outdoor lift in Europe. Oh my god, so beautiful! And right before you leave Lucerne, a nice little souvenir for you to get a hold of would of course be the Swiss Army knife. So do drop by the Victorinox factory and customize your very own Swiss Army knife. Next, you want to hop on a train and head to Interlaken. So it's a very good base if you want to travel to the surrounding attractions. So one such attraction will be the Virojammerbahn, the world's steepest open-air funicular. Its incline stands at a staggering 106 degrees. Pro tip, you might want to get into the queue early to get into the first two rows for unobstructed views as you ascend up the mountain. And at the top, take a quick stroll over to German Lake and enjoy its gorgeous turquoise waters. And if you like German Lake and you like blue-ass water, you can also head over to the small fishing village nearby. The views are simply magical. You get a view of the castle across the blue waters of Lake Brienz. You can have a picnic there, or you can just watch the sunset across the horizon. Okay, come on, the views look like something straight out of a screensaver. How romantic. While Interlaken, also consider exploring the nearby town of Lauterbrunnen. So it's a quaint little valley town that's full of charm. You can even go paragliding between the valleys of Lauterbrunnen. You'll fly really close to the rock faces and waterfalls, all while enjoying the mesmerizing views of the Swiss Alps in the distance. And right next to your landing spot is the cable car station that brings you all the way up to Schilthorn. There you can take on the Thrill Walk, which is a 200 meter walkway of clear glass panels overlooking plunging depths of over 2,000 meters. And right before leaving Interlaken, head over to Jungfrau for icy air and views of Switzerland's 4,000 meter peaks. The train ride up is really, really scenic, and you get to experience snow right at the top. It is time to hop on another train, and this time your train is heading to Montreux. The famous route between Interlaken and Montreux is called the Golden Pass Line, which brings you across the dreamiest sights across Switzerland. In Montreux, you can check out the Chillon Castle. It's known as Switzerland's grandest castle for very good reason. It looks like something out of a Disney princess movie. You can also stop by the Lucerne Thermal Baths en route to your next destination. It's the largest thermal spa resort in the Swiss Alps with natural thermal waters rich in minerals. It's just what you need after days of hiking and adventuring. And our next city will be Zermatt. It is home to the famous Matterhorn Mountain, aka the Toblerone Chocolate Mountain. Zermatt is a car-free town that has ski slopes open all days of the year, but we are here for the main attraction, Matterhorn. You want to wake up really early to catch the sunrise because you get to see warm orange hues creeping up behind the mountain, and just look at it. It's so nice, it's beautiful. And of course, you want to grab a Toblerone chocolate bar when you're there too, just for the gram. And if you like, you can take a hike to catch the views from all angles. And we are hopping on another train now, but this train is special because this is the Glacier Express, and it is the queen of railways in Switzerland. This 8-hour picturesque ride is so popular, you're actually advised to make reservations at least a month in advance. The final stop of the Glacier Express is St. Moritz, a popular town with luxurious alpine resorts. So we didn't stay here for too long, but the one thing we had to check out was the Landwasser Viaduct viewpoint. This has to be one of the most photographed railways in the world, and you may have glimpsed it while you were on the Glacier Express, but seeing it from above, it's a whole different experience. And our last stop of our Swiss rail adventure will be in Zurich. It's a bustling city with historical charm. Zurich offers a change of pace after days spent amongst nature. Here we got to explore Zurich's old town, and when you're there, look out for the Twin Towers of Grossmünster, one of Zurich's most prominent historical landmarks. And one of the best things you can do there is to visit Rhine Falls. It is Europe's largest waterfall, which stands at 23 meters. You can even take a boat out to get a more intimate experience to feel the full force of the falls at close proximity. When I say intimate, I mean you're gonna get wet, but it's all good fun. And our last stop would be to walk up Lindenhof Hill to see the cityscapes of Zurich and catch the beautiful sunset from the viewpoint, so you get to wind down and reflect on your amazing trip and all the money that you spent. But that's okay, because the views here, you don't get that anywhere else in the world. And that is it for our Switzerland budget guide. We've seen so many gorgeous destinations, we've taken so many train rides, we've hiked up so many majestic mountains, and hopefully you get to experience this one day for yourself. And if there's anything that you recommend to do in Switzerland, please remember to leave a comment below, leave a like if you liked it, and for more travel guides and stupid vlogs, do subscribe to our channel as well. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and at the very least, I hope it gave you a little bit of inspiration to plan your next trip to Switzerland. We will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.